It is pretty well known that animals can actually rely on their sensory skills in order to locate prey, find their predators, and even find their mates, which ultimately determines their evolutionary success. Now, what is very fascinating and sometimes very humbling to us is that they do it with minimum amount of resources. They consume very little amount of energy, and their tiny brains can perform computational tasks, which are essentially very difficult even for the modern day computers.
We are trying to mimic their functionality into our devices, and just learning about biology, how animals around us behave, is very interesting for me.
Nature is not only beautiful, but also it is very smart, and this is very deep-rooted in everyone who's working in this group.
We're doing something brand new. We're connecting nature and technology in a way that no one else quite has before.
So the primary focus of our research is to develop an unified platform for the next generations of ultra-low power and artificially intelligent sensors, which can not only sense the data from the environment, but can also process that information. It can actually store that information. And at the end of the day, it can also communicate that information among each other without compromising the security of the information.
So whether we're trying to sense a virus, sense an earthquake, sense changes in the climate, or critical risks that we face, having better sensors means better information, and better information means better outcomes.
These new sensors that we are developing in this era of Internet of Things is that there is so many of them. In fact, there will be almost like close to a trillion sensors by the year 2030. And each of them are going to consume energy. And the total energy consumption is going to reach almost 20% of the total energy expenditure that the human population uses. And unless and until we essentially solve this problem and make these sensors energy efficient, we will not be able to cope with these energy challenges. Really, if we want to move towards a sustainable future, we need to make sure that we make these sensors as energy efficient as possible.